Hi everyone, welcome to this video, Some Frontier video. My name is Jay Wakefield. Now, a couple of weeks ago, I actually bought a laptop that Billy Carr still owns, a Dell Inspiron 6000. Now, that was a machine he used from 2006 through until he got his Dell Vostro 1500, I think it was sometime in 2008. Now, that Vostro, to him, was actually a replacement for the machine that he was using before, which was a Dell Inspiron 1150. You know, Billy used that from 2004 to 2005, I believe. Yeah, I think that sounds about right. Yeah, only lasted him about a year before the motherboard failed. Now, this got me thinking, you know, we started chatting about 2000s laptops and what we were all using at the time. Now, my first laptop in 2002 was an old Mytac with a monochrome screen. That was my very first laptop. I used to tote that around in 2002. My poor teacher used to have to find a plug for me because obviously the damn thing didn't have any battery anywhere. It ran Windows 3.1, although I upgraded it to Windows Workgroup 3.11. Had an 81 megs of hard disk space free. That's what the drive capacity was. It's formatted capacity. I don't know what its full capacity was, but its formatted capacity was 81 megs. It had 4 megs of memory, and it ran Windows. Well, I installed Windows Workgroup 3.11 on it, and I also installed Microsoft Office 4.2, and that's how I used to use it. I got that in 2002. Unfortunately, it broke probably about a month or 2 months later, which is a bit of a shame. Now, I had this laptop. In 2003, actually, because I was actually in foster care. In 2003, the local social services decided that every foster child needed access to the internet, which, do you know what, is actually extremely admirable. So what they would do is they were actually giving out computers to, they were actually giving computers to every home, every foster carer, they were giving away computers to, like, all the foster carers to, so that their looked after children could actually use them, for, the idea was that they would be able to use them to kind of further their education, homework, studies. And these machines were, they weren't bad, obviously, they weren't extreme powerhouses, but at the same time, they weren't actually terrible, like, cheap, nasty pieces of, repurposed rubbish, either. These were brand new, as far as I'm aware, these were brand new, out-of-the-box computers, built by a company called Stone Computers, which I believe was based down in Bradford in England. And these machines had, they came with, as far as I remember, because I've actually had to service a couple of these machines in my time, as far as I remember, they came with a Pentium 4. They were all Pentium 4 powered, they were all with an Intel. If it wasn't an Intel motherboard, it was certainly a board with an Intel chipset. It'll probably be, will have been something like an 845 series or something of that style. Pentium 4, probably about 1.7 gigahertz. And I'm not sure about the RAM, it's probably 256 or 512. And they had, you know, probably a 20, 30 or 40 gig hard disk. And they came with quite a large CRT monitor, you know, keyboard, mouse, printer. And they would even pay for a second phone line to be installed, so that the kids could access broadband, the internet. Obviously, you know, that it would be up to the foster carers to actually pay, you know, for the internet connection and what have you. You know, and the upkeep of all that. But, you know, social services would actually pay for the installation of a second phone line so that, you know, tying up the phone. These machines also came, well, they came preloaded from social services, I must actually hasten to add. They came loaded with Windows XP. The desktop computers came with Windows XP Home Edition. And they... And social services put a few things on them. You know, there was a kind of a child's office suite, but then there was also Microsoft Office XP Standard. There was, and there was a copy of NetNanny as well. NetNanny, now that... That was the worst thing in the world. I mean, for the first 2 years, well, I mean, I'll get back to that, but NetNanny would block the local football team's website, but there's a lot of adult websites that it would actually allow through. So actually, that said, it was terrible, and it kept on crashing and corrupting itself. I mean, you know, it was just really, really not good. Now, when this was happening, I already had a desktop computer, the 2001 custom built. But my mum was saying, well, he could use a laptop. So basically what social services were able to do for me is actually supplied me with a laptop. Now, I remember the day that I got it. I mean, I had absolutely no idea that this was happening. I just, you know, it was just one day, you came home from school, as you do, you know, in April 2003. I just set about doing whatever it is that I do, installing Windows 95 on the 2001 custom built to mess about with it, I believe, while watching The Simpsons. And then my mum came in, and called me, you know, down the stairs, and she's like, I've got something for you. And it was, you know, she was holding this laptop in a bag behind her back, and it was like, yeah, social service got you a laptop. I was just pure amazed. It was like, it was my own machine, and it was, this is not it. Seriously, this is not the laptop. It's, in fact, it's not even the same machine. It's not even the machine that I got. So why am I even showing you this? Why did I even waste your time telling that story? Well, it's very similar to the machine that I got. The machine that I got was a Samsung V20 laptop. It was actually better spec'd than the desktop PCs that they were handing out. Because mine's was a 2.4 gigahertz Pentium 4. Obviously, didn't realize at the time that, well, I, you know, kind of figured it was a desktop processor, but that it was putting a desktop processor in a laptop is no good. And it was a 2.4 gig processor, 512 megs of RAM, 30 gig hard drive, 64 meg Intel 845, I believe, chip video drivers, and DVD-ROM CDRW drive. And, I love that thing. Seriously, that just made my 2003. I mean, I didn't take it to school at first when I, you know, first got the machine. but a year later I did. Unfortunately, 6 months after owning the machine, it actually, the screen actually broke. It was, the colours all became kind of screwed up and what have you. And it just didn't work properly, and it was, something had actually melted. And that, I think, was this laptop's Achilles heel. It was designed and built by idiots. You know, so I had my V20 for 2 years. Unfortunately, it was in a... Unfortunately, it kind of met its end when the bag that it was in actually broke around my shoulder and the machine came falling to the floor. Now, I didn't stop to test it. I was actually away the night that it broke. I went away, took the machine with me, and only realised that it had broken when... Oh, James, what am I trying to say? When I powered it on and realised I couldn't do hee-haw with it. So, suffice it to say, I was not pleased at all. I was just like, I just banged the lid of the machine down hard. I was just like, I'm not going to do it with this one. But, yeah. So, I mean, for a while I've been wanting to get an example of my childhood laptop back. And I've not found one. But this, like I said, is quite close to the machine I had from 2003 up until October 2005. Samsung. Now, what this is a Samsung V25. So this is the next model up. See, the Samsung V20s in the Argos catalogue seem to, and wherever else I found them, they all seem to sell with 14-inch screens. So they had a wide, slightly wider bezel, DVD-ROM only, and a 1.7 gigahertz, I think it was a Celeron, and a 20 gig hard drive, whereas my V20 came with a 15-inch screen. Oh yeah, and the ones in the catalogue had 256 megs of RAM. Probably you could actually obvious to me that now that, you know, you'd ring Samsung up and they would actually, you know, you could actually order a laptop, you know, to your specification. Didn't really kind of think things through properly then. I mean, what was I thinking? Social services just kind of go to Argos and then pick up a laptop or something. You know, just got this poor social worker sat there and order 389 to your collection point, please. No, but I was very thankful, you know, that they did that for me, you know, and it really helped me a deal. It really helped me a bundle, you know, kind of having access to my own laptop. I mean, in 2003 and 4, it was literally people were just starting to kind of get access to machines. My friend Jonathan had his Dell Latitude CPT, you know, and then I had my Samsung V20. I am ashamed to say, but feel that it should be said that while Jonathan was quite willing to lend his laptop out to anyone in need, I kind of guarded mine with my life because it had broken before. So I'm really sorry about that, Spike. He let me use it a few times in lessons. I was really appreciative of it. You know, it was great. I liked it. But yeah, I mean, my V20 went all the way. You know, my V20 went, you know, everywhere with me. You know, I took it away in the caravan. I took it when I went to a revision weekend. Just anywhere I would go, so too it would go. And it was brilliant, actually, because I, because it had a DVD drive on it, you know, I was able, you know, if we were away on a caravan holiday, I was able to just kind of sit there and play DVDs, which I thought was fantastic, or do homework or what have you. Anyway, this machine, V25, Pentium 4, 2.8 gigahertz, 40 gig hard drive, boots to BIOS as far as I'm aware. I don't know this. So, very bad condition. Cosmetically, it's a dog. So on the left, what we have is Kensington lock slot. Then we have a door which reveals to you an F-video port. Now with my V20, I actually did buy cabling for that so we could actually play DVDs through the television, because the only, well, my 2001 custom built had a DVD player, but yeah, could actually play DVDs. Oh, jings. What am I trying to say? I could actually play, you know, connect my laptop up down the stairs and play some DVDs through that, through the TV down the stairs, which was good. DB9 serial port, SPDIF, out. It would actually light itself up red. But you can all obviously plug regular headphones in. Microphone. Battery compartment. Two speakers, and you can tell here where the silver paintwork has worn off. It's another hallmark sign of quality from the 2000s. The painted machines. The paint would just kind of come off and make the machines look tatty and old. I mean, the laptop that I got to replace this was kind of a flannel, kind of gunmetal-ish grey. I'm going to say gunmetal because it was a wee bit shiny. It wasn't kind of dull matte. It was kind of painted, so it had kind of a gunmetal-coloured finish. And after only a few short months of having it, it too looked like a bit of a dog. On this side, you've got a PC card or card bus slot, hard drive compartment, DVD, ROM, CDRW, combi drive. And on the back, you've got PS2 mouse and keyboard port, Ethernet 56K modem, mini FireWire, two USB 2 ports, IEEE 1284 parallel printer port, VGA out, DC, and a very much used vent. Now, unfortunately, this machine is, well, as you can see, it is in terrible condition. There's cracked plastic. These kind of tabs are missing. And, you know, and then the lead is heavily scratched. It's got sticker residue. Cosmetically, it looks very bad. Not that my V20 looked storeroom fresh. This model is actually a V25. And one of the things that actually differentiates it from my V20 is that the Samsung logo on my V20 was actually a blue kind of oval. You know, that was kind of raised with Samsung written on it, whereas this is a wee metal Samsung nameplate. So this machine is a Samsung V25. What we're waiting to do is plug it in. And I hope it works and doesn't bang. Smoke test! Okay, that didn't work. That didn't work. Okay, seems that I'm going to need a different plug. Be right back. Okay, so the machine's got power. Now, if we look on the inside, you can't see because there's limited light here, but the keyboard is a nice kind of shade of blue, and there's another vent up here, speakers are down here, and you think, it's not too bad on the inside. Then you notice a scratch, and you think, well, still not too bad. And then you notice the left bezel of the screen. Yeah. Use it to play the guitar. I mean, I could glue it back together, but quite frankly, I mean, I wouldn't mind getting just another bezel. Now, I am using a universal power adapter with this, but that doesn't actually ruin the nostalgia as much as you... well, I mean, obviously it doesn't anyway, but it's actually a wee bit more correct than it would normally be. See, I had the power adapter The original power adapter for my Samsung V20 actually, well, it died in 2005. It actually died in August 2005. So before this new school year started, I actually had to get another one. And I ended up getting a big, massive hulk of a thing from Maplin. And it wasn't any of this fancy digital nonsense that we have today. It's actually, I quite like it. It was the older style, you know, where you got a wee turnkey and you'd kind of select the voltage and then, you know, choose the end. It worked. It was a lot bigger than the regular power adapter for this machine, but I don't know if it was due to the age or whether it was due to the actual power adapter itself, but around that time, the battery never did get charged fully, you know? I could get probably about 30 minutes tops out of it. But, I mean, this machine, I mean, the battery, the charging, it's just ridiculous. Seriously, I mean, what you'd get is instructions on charging, and I had the original manual for mine. The V20, I don't know if it's the same in the V25, I'm guessing it pretty much is. The battery, it would say that the battery would last for 2.5 hours. I mean, obviously, you know, when a manufacturer claims, you know, a time for the battery to last, what they mean is if you switch everything off, kind of run this processor at the slowest speed, no wireless, put the screen at practically no brightness at all, you might actually get 2 hours, 29 minutes, and 29 seconds out of that. Maybe, if you're lucky, you will get 2 hours and 30 minutes. And 0 seconds. Actual reality, you know, we use the screen, we use wireless, we use that sort of stuff. We use optical drives, or we did back in the day. Fans spin up, you know, it's just kind of symptomatic of a, you know, basically regular laptop usage. The machine's going to last a lot less time than that. I mean, that's fine. You know, it's got a desktop processor. That's okay. You know, if I wanted a more portable machine, Samsung did actually sell more portable ones. And Intel's Centrino... whatever you want to call it, was coming out. You know, Centrino machines were coming out. Brilliant marketing by Intel, by the way. Just absolutely brilliant. You know, and they kind of claimed, oh, portability, this, that, and the other, massive battery life, brilliant wireless, such portability, so amazing, wow. And, you know, you could obviously just get a machine like that, you know, with a mobile Pentium 4, Celeron, or, you know, even a Pentium 3. Did not long stop using Pentium 3s in laptops by this time. So, would last 2.5 hours. Maybe. On a good day. Only if you eat your vegetables. And even then it might not. but the charging time, that's what got me. Charging. I mean, it's like a modern laptop, you know, it'll charge. It's like my, you know, my ThinkPad, you know, I can plug it in for an hour and, you know, probably got about, you know, it'll probably charge about 50% of the battery. You know, brilliant. This machine, it said, and I quote, if you leave them, well, actually, I don't quote at all. It was 11 years ago since I read the manual to this machine, to the V20. But, if you leave the machine powered off, put it on charge, you'll maybe get 4 hours. It'll take 4 hours. 4 hours to charge. Already, it's going to take longer to charge the bloody thing than it would to actually use it. Such was technology, though. And how is it switched off? Take longer to charge it than it would to use it. I mean, James, you'd think Samsung had supplied a blooming hand crank with it. Actually, that would have taken even longer. You'd probably break your arm trying to blooming hand crank one of these back to life. But, yeah. the if you, I don't know, let's say you committed the heinous crime of switching it on while it was charging, then it could take 10 hours. 10 hours to charge the machine while it was switched on. So let's surmise. You take it into the office. It's 9 to 5. Okay, that's 8 hours. The battery's completely pancake flat dead. Okay? You plug it in. You set it up at your desk. You use it. You go home. You take the machine on the road. You've got to stop off somewhere on the way home. Maybe have a wee meeting at some client's place just before you go home. Don't know why you would do that after 5, but bear with me. And your machine is still not fully charged. Yeah. Such was technology, though. I mean, I don't know how other machines of the time compared, but that's what the V20 did, and yeah. Anyway, enough of me blethering. 26 minutes into the video, let's power it on. Oh, wow. I tell you, this brings back memories. The blue LEDs in there. You see, this is another thing. The V20s in the catalogue were shown with green LEDs, but mine had the blue ones. Anyway, let's have a look. Pentium 4 2.8 GHz. Looks like it's got 512 megs of RAM. DVD-CD-ROM. Well, it says DVD-ROM-CDRW combi in the thing. And, yeah, just regular kind of BIOS. So what I'm going to do, I'm actually just going to load the setup defaults. And, can you believe it? This is nearly, the date and time on this is actually nearly correct. So I'm just going to say, yep, it's actually Thanksgiving Day in the United States. So happy Thanksgiving, everyone. Please do not get too drunk on your turkey cranberry sauce and Thanksgiving Day halftime show. So, operating system not found. So what I will do is I will... This video, I think, has gotten long enough. Really sorry, guys. But what I will do is... I will go and install probably Windows XP. There is a COA for it on the bottom. And, you know, we'll get a look in at this machine once it's all installed. And we're going to try the V20 driver CD, because it's probably not going to work because it's a different laptop. Or I could just go on the computer and look for V25 drivers. That's what I might do, actually. But with that said, I hope you've enjoyed watching my video. Thank you for watching it. If you've enjoyed it, please feel free to subscribe to my channel. And it's actually been 9 years since I've seen one of these with a working screen. At least I think it has. But I hope you all have enjoyed this video. If you have, please feel free to subscribe. Please feel free to like us on Facebook. And please feel free to follow my blog. But that said, thank you for watching this video. And I hope you'll all join me for my next one. Doodoo bye.